Good afternoon, sports fans. My name is Magnitude.
And I am Ryan, back from the motherfucking dead. If you poured one out for me, fucking put it back in your bottle.
And after that long-winded entrance, I'm your friendly neighborhood Andy Man.
Welcome to Magnation Green, episode 93. Before this match started, guys, be sure to leave a like on this video if you enjoyed it on the channel. Fuck. Yeah.
Spilled water on myself.
Oh, you spilled it out. One for yourself. That's no good. Comment on the video. We enjoy the comments. Follow us on Twitter, on Facebook. Subscribe for more. And let's get into it. This is a Patreon requested match by our man Savider.
Oh,
Savider.
Yes. We've also added a third patron. In post, I'll be adding graphics. So if you see me just randomly talk about Patreon, just go with it.
Going.
Our man, Brazzle Dazzle, the man who,
Brazzle Dazzle.
Yeah, our match writer has become a patron as well. So we have three patrons now. Three of them.
Count them. One, two, three.
And you didn't even want to make a
patron. Count them on your toes.
I did not. I did not think it was going to yield a reward. But it's helping paying for the hosting every month, the website. Which, speaking of the website, Andy, what's the website we have?
M4GNation.
Nation.com, M4GNation.com. Go there every day. Got a lot of cool stuff. Always working on it. And, you know, be sure to check that shit out. To do it. This is a match from our man, Savider. Our first patron. He's requested Joey Wheeler versus Yugi Moto.
Ooh.
Yeah.
I see Yugi has he's a bit of a show-off. I mean, well, I would too.
This is manga Yamayugi.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Yeah, it has to be. I mean, look at him. It's what happens.
I mean, I never read the manga, so...
It's like
I do know
like
that it's way fucking different.
Gotta be.
Yeah, it's less about... Alright, Broly's literally sniffing my microphone now, so if you hear random thudding, it's because his big fucking fat fucking nose is getting in the way. Yeah, it's like not even about the card game. It's about ruining lives.
Well, yeah, because, like, I've heard that, like Yami has kind of, like a sadistic, like, dark sense of humor, like, in the manga. Like, he's, like, a little bit of an asshole that likes to fuck with people.
Yeah, that's accurate. That is accurate. that's the sound of Broly satiating his thirst with his fat fucking tongue. Here comes Joey Wheeler. Sorry, I cut you off.
Asian.
Hey, I'm bringing the boom, y'all. Hey, I'm fucking walking over here. Hey, Brooklyn representing. Oh,
you guys good?
Yeah.
They'll probably be more eventually.
Alright, so here's Yugi Moto, Joey Wheeler. This is a rematch of their duel at Duelist Kingdom and their duel at the pier and their duel in. Did they duel again after that? No, they did not. Just those two. Rematch of those, which Yugi won both of them. So there you go.
Hey, yo.
What? Ancelo beat the...
You're lagging, Andy. Fix your shit. Fix your shit, Andy. Neckbreaker by Joey Wheeler to open the match.
And... Oh, a sitting stomp thing.
Sitting stomp thing. Devastating.
A Mario ground pound.
Close enough.
It's a Mia Yug. It's a Mia.
Hey, it's Italian. We're from Brooklyn, too.
That's Mama Joey to you, Yug.
I just want to let you guys know that I'm on my third slice of individual cheese tonight. Flying Splash by Joey Wheeler. Individual cheese
what
slices.
Kind of cheese?
Just cheese slices. Okay. Yeah.
Like but he can't say craft.
Craft singles.
Singles.
Yeah.
I remember I enjoyed eating them individually when I was a kid, but like, I don't know, as I grew older, like, they kind of grew more and more gross to me. Like, I still wish I enjoyed them because they're really cheap, but alas, my tastes have changed.
Forlorn you are for cheeses.
Yeah. Alas, poor... For, I was trying to think of a cheese pun with Yorick, but I couldn't think of one.
That's okay. I forgive you. Punches by... What a dropkick!
Dropkick!
I wonder why it's called a dropkick. I understand that you like have to... Why isn't it called a jump kick?
Yeah, that's a good point.
You have to
probably.
Ooh,
maybe the implication is that, like, when you kick him, you, like, pretty much fucking drop him to the ground, like, when you do it. Well, no, because I've seen people get, like, on the ground get drop kicked, so that's not.
It doesn't seem very effective, though. Dropping cover by out. Joey Wheeler 1. I think just stomping on people.
I saw this fucking video, like, this bully, like, bullying this kid, and, like, he had the kid on the ground and was, like, punching him, and some guy ran up and fucking drop-kicked the bully in the back of the head, and he just went fucking limp. It was great.
Bully burger.
Ooh. Got that... not pile driver, but, yeah, whatever.
Indeed.
Hey, Andy, picking up where you left off last week. Hopefully the audio is less fucked than last week, because that was a goddamn nightmare.
Yo, how is this, bro?
Andy, you're still lagging.
Damn it!
Can't fix that.
You can't fix stupid. Get her done.
Uh-oh, top bro for Yugi. There's our Lair of the Cable reference for the week. What a flying elbow by Yugi. He calls it the Curse of Dragon 1.
Question, what is a Frankensteiner?
Yes.
No, what is that?
It's like a straight Hurricane Rana.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because when I was a kid, I used to play this PS1 game called WCW NWO Thunder.
Hell yeah, you did. That was a good game.
Yeah, and I remember a move being called a Frankensteiner, like, yep, when I played that game, but I couldn't remember what move
it was. It's like a straight-on Hurricane Rana. Or is Hurricane Rana kind of like there's a little twist involved, or Frankensteiner just like... What a moonsault by Yugi.
Oh, my lord.
Wow.
So basically, it'd be like if they did a front flip and, like, grabbed him with the legs and then just went straight back.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
If it had no flair, it's a Frankensteiner.
Yes. Yes, that's essentially it.
All right.
Yugi.
I think King does that in Tekken.
He does.
Yeah, he definitely does.
All right, he's got him by the head.
He does. And... astute observation. That one guy there is really pumped. Again, black shirt. Super amped.
Dragging his limp body.
His limp corpse. Hook of the leg. Raditz. Right there. He's happy to be back at the ring, as he noted. He was not there for the March Madness tournament. This is Kobe Bryant. What strength by Yugi Moto. Jesus.
Now this is old man Raditz. He definitely aged. Seething. Salt wind. Going to the top rope.
Top rope for
Yugi Moto. Getting out of the way. Oh, where is he?
Flying DDT!
I don't think I've ever seen that before.
Top rope DDT by Joey Wheeler.
Oh, Yugi, I think he's dead.
He might have died.
Now taunt Joey, his best friend.
As Joey Wheeler does.
Ooh, kick to the face.
Oh!
The flaming sword of battle. The swordsman of Landstar.
Yeah, I was
Red Eyes Black Dragon.
Red Eyes Black Dragon.
One, two.
Attack the moon.
Ooh! Yugi Moto just able to kick out, and Joe Wheeler is not happy about that.
The Super Mario Ground Pound.
Super Mario Ground Pound.
More like Mario 64.
Well, he does that in, like, every game since Mario 64. So I just call it the Super Mario Ground Pound. There's more games in which he can do the ground pound than games which he cannot.
One. Two. Kick out at two. Yugi Moto. He seems in a little bit of disbelief right now.
Going to the outside.
He's already springboarded. Did a moonsault once today. It's not really a moonsault territory, but springboard elbow to the face. The crowd absolutely loving it.
Hook of the leg.
One. Tooth. Yep.
That's going to be it.
Yugi Moto. Wow. Joey Wheeler on a bit of a losing streak now.
Wow, especially the Yama Yugi. That's probably his first singles win.
We know that because we definitely saw the cards on the entrances. So we know for sure if that is a fact or not. There's no need to dispute that at all. That was a... I've also never seen a top rope DDT from Joey Wheeler before. But that was pretty cool. That hurt a lot. How do you just... You pretty much just fall... You're like jumping and you're falling on your ass. That's all you're doing. I'm sure you got their head there. But...
Yeah, but... It's head with you, though.
Yeah, it doesn't help the pain against you. But, you know...
Hey. Sacrificing one's cossacks is a small price to pay for the smarty...
Lagging, what are you doing?
He's watching... Boo. He's watching some G-MILF porn.
G-MILF porn.
G-MILF?
Yeah. G-MILF.
Like grannies. Grandma?
Yes, grannies. Squirting grannies.
Wouldn't that just be GILF?
Really? I mean, it depends on whether or not grandma is one or two words for you. Well, or grandmother.
An old granny I'd like to fuck.
Oh. We got a promotion thing.
Yeah, what is going to happen with that vacant green title, Andy? What do you think?
It's got to be something good.
It's got to be Kane.
Oh, well, Javier's here now. Whoa, when did that happen?
Elimination Chamber, apparently, is what's going to be happening.
Oh, let's go.
Which means qualifying matches are here.
Woo! Is this one of them?
That was bad. Correct. That is what. Yeah. What? You got to pay attention, Javier. Speaking of that, Javier's here, guys. As you obviously know, qualifying matches. Yeah, there will be six of them. Of course, that's the way that works. And the winners of those matches will then take part in an Elimination Chamber match for the vacated Magnation Green title, which we're all looking forward to and excited to be a part of. Oh boy, did I ever forget? We're still going though. That's fine. I fixed it. The problem solved. I just forgot to mute. I forgot to mute Premiere audio, so there's a little bit of an overlay with Premiere's audio. Here goes Master Chief, though, on his way.
Master Chief.
Yeah, he's about to try to cook up a victory here against Jack Six. Gonna be, it's gonna be a tough one, but, you know.
Did you ever win green, blue, or main title back?
Well, if you went to the website, Javier, you can tell me.
Oh, shit, you're right.
That's right.
Yeah, what website is that, Andy?
That's 4GNation.com.
Now you're lagging.
All right.
Magnation.com, M4GNation.com.
Buy a shirt.
Buy a shirt. Wait, why not?
Buy a shirt.
Buy a shirt, guys.
Ring the bell. Be our bell bros.
I mean, it's not required. Actually, you know what? Do that. Because it's
really, it is required if you want to get...
Yeah, apparently YouTube is, like, notifying... or not notifying people.
Yeah, I never really understood, like, the uproar of that. Because, yeah, like...
I don't know.
Well, because they're like, oh, like, you have to, like, click the bell thing to, like, get a notification when somebody uploads. It's like, okay, I'm subscribed to, like, 100 channels. I don't want to get 100, like, fucking notifications a day whenever somebody uploads.
Well, I guess a lot of people are saying that subscribe to channels you want to see
notifications
anyway.
No, I don't.
I'm just saying.
Don't subscribe to that channel.
Well, no, I want to subscribe to them and then look at my subscription feed every day for when they upload a video. I don't want to be notified about it. Because that's just going to ruin my phone with notifications.
Going to ruin his phone. Going to be ruined with notifications.
Like, am I seriously the only person who, like, hates getting, like, billions of notifications?
Oh, I thought that was notifications.
Am I the only person who actually bothers to go to the subscription feed to see, like, whenever channels I'm subbed to have uploaded?
You might be.
Yeah.
Here comes Jack Six, though. Nothing,
he's
guys.
Coming.
Nothing.
What? I said Jack Six.
You didn't.
Three.
You're lagging. Is it me who's lagging? Nah. Is it me who's lagging? It might be. It's possible.
No. It's me.
I don't know. Well, yeah, no, I've heard both of them lag.
Alright, so then it's not me. Alright, then it's not. Okay, it's not. Cool. That's fine. I can deal with that. I'm cool with that.
No. It's not you. I invented it.
I understand what you're doing, but it's your
time. You invented lag, apparently, because you're fucking... You keep lagging, boy.
You do.
Jack 6, formerly a 3-time main champion, 1-time galactic.
That's right. Javier, using that information on the website. And using it well.
I think it would be cool if Bojack put like former champions on this, so like it makes the Green Title Chamber match more prestigious.
He may. I don't really have any control over that, but you guys can. Yep. You guys take over because I have to get a laptop charger that works. As mine right now isn't working, so you guys have the floor until I come back.
All right, and off we go. We're off to the races as Master Chief runs around the corner, followed by Jack 6.
Oh, what a wallop!
What a lovely day for racing, for wrestling. Wrestling racing.
We should do that again, though. Like,
get a tournament on me.
Ooh, a clothesline.
Well, the champion of champions should be crowned.
Exactly.
Master Chief sweeps the leg. And now he's doing that thing, the leg lock. Leg lock. Jack 6 is
the trunks of that big redwood. That is Jack 6.
Trunks. I mean, no. Jack 6 is just robot trunks. That's all he is.
Okay.
Punish it.
Jack 6. Oh my lord. Really trying to break through that helmet.
Now, should Master Chief really be here right now? Ouch.
I mean, maybe. He's super strong.
I return.
Power bomb? Ooh, an emphatic power bomb.
Emphatic, huh?
Lift it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm trying to see if what's his name? Ever faced Master Chief before.
Who?
If Jack 6 and Master Chief have faced off in the past.
Oh.
By checking that website.
That's
all exactly information.
Alright, he's strapped. Oh, now he's just punching Master Chief in the face. They're outside the ring, by the way.
Well, for good thing he has a helmet. Or else he would probably be dead.
Not watching.
The ground and pound game is Jack 6.
He is.
Can Mag Nation get an assisted audio option? Or is just a pleasant voice like describing like everything that's happening? Like, I mean, that's what we're supposed to be for, but, you know.
Fuck that.
Yeah, what are we
just complaining about random shit.
Jack 6 is thrown into the announcer's table. Oh, we're getting spooked.
Oh, no.
Whoa, is PC this, principal.
He's facing a giant robot. A giant robot slammed into our table.
Yeah.
Jack 6. Wow. Cranking
wrenching
that arm.
That arm. Throwing his opponent into the corner.
What's he gonna do? Oh,
puts him in a tree of low position. And just the life out of Master Chef.
Jack 6 with a submission, it looks like? I don't know.
We're trying to make him humble. Pontiac,
little bitch. Whatever. Hold up, little bitch.
Oh, right to
Master Chief on the offensive now.
Oh, shh.
Wrenching the
thing with that snapmare. A lot of action going on in the back. Crosshold.
I don't hear that, Andy. What are you talking about? Jack 6 sitting up.
Yes. Whatever do you mean, my companion? And,
Oh. I see your style. But you're not flying my... Sure.
You cannot
fly on the top. He usually doesn't fly unless it's in a spaceship. Oh,
okay. I am not a penis. You cannot block my soil.
Oh, yes.
Take down on Jack 6.
Right. Try to block my soil, right?
I have never seen this soil before.
How are you guys referencing? It sounds familiar.
South Park.
South Park. Oh, out here. South Park.
When they were making fun of Mark Zuckerberg.
You cannot block my soil.
Oh, my head! Oh, get out of here, you penis!
It's unsuccessful in finding a charger. That's, I gotta, this is indeed.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, it's not good.
Just blow, one, okay, one count. Just blow into the charger port as hard as you can to give it extra power.
Perfect. So, no. Steve, yeah. I found out, Master Chief and Jack Six.
Oh, no! Take it out, old man Rats!
Chamber Rats, master, is down. Rats is down for the 10 millionth time in his career, sadly. So this is
Jack
a fitting
Six,
match.
Top rope, and jumps.
Boo! Out.
Where are many numbers on the amount of time Rats has fallen? This is,
And a second backbreaker.
He's had a save on his, like, notes. Taken down by Master Chief this week.
This is a live counter.
God damn. Jack Six is just ruthless.
He's trying to break through that helmet, James.
And suplex. Oh, wait. Oh, you got a second suplex going.
Supply.
Can we get a third one? Three for the price of one.
Suplex City, population Master Chef.
Three for the price of one.
Sizing him up. Oh, but Master Chief counters.
You know, Spine Buster.
Oh, is he instant Buster. Transmissions? Hook of the leg. One, two, and that's not gonna do it.
Almost. Jack Six is a bigger man, but like Master Chief is surprisingly holding though. Those sides are different, at least. Oh,
yeah,
but he turns
like
his back.
He weighs like 1,000 pounds with that armor on.
Oh god! German. Off the second rope.
Punch to the gut.
A reverse.
Oh, it's Master Chief. Yeah, reverses.
Actually putting in some offense. Ooh,
DDT. Sizing him up.
Oh.
And, oh, what is this?
Pedigree.
Ouch.
Didn't it?
Oh, Raditz actually recoiled from that. Did you see that? One.
Two. Oh,
ooh,
that was really close.
Yeah, Raditz, like very visibly like jumped back from that, and like he put his hands up like as if like it scared him.
I mean, like how much do you think Jack Six weighs? Since he's a giant robot,
probably a few hundred pounds.
So like that's just probably a ton, a metric ton.
So 2,000 pounds?
Yeah, that just got dropped right next to you.
It's a metric ton. It's different.
No,
yeah, man.
Yeah,
that's like 2,500 kilos.
Yeah, 2,000 pounds.
Ooh!
Oh, my God!
That armor ain't helping that. Oh, shit. Surprised it didn't go through
the... I think this is the end right here. One, two... No, oh, no! Oh, how can he still fight back after that?
Off the ropes? No way. Picking up his opponent!
Lifting him in that heavy armor. The floor. Or deadlifting him. Makes his own Germans
suplex.
Again. Oh, he is a former Green Champion. Let me win that.
Are we going to see a powerbomb right here?
That's
emphatic powerbomb.
It's all core right there, baby. It's all core.
Hardcore. Going for a RKO or cutter. Just trying to be fancy at this point, you know.
Ooh, a knee to the face.
Can't really compare to Brock Lesnar. Just trying to break through the helmet at this point. Chinks in the armor. Hearing. He's going for... Turtle to whirl.
Just throw him around like a rag doll.
Just the best ride out of Carnival.
The who?
The Turtle to whirl.
Oh, this is the best ride out of Farmville. I think that's fucking
what?
That's why I questioned. I had no idea what you were saying.
Do you guys know the? Did you guys ever have the Ring of Fire ride like at your like fairs and carnivals?
No.
Okay, it's basically this like this fire. Ride that like goes in a giant like circle. It's like, okay, hold on, hook of the leg. One, two.
Ooh,
not quite.
The end videos you talk about the Ring of Fire.
But yeah, anyways, it's like a roller coaster essentially, where it just goes in like a giant loop, like up in the air and back down. And I remember like when I was like 8, I like rode it, but like I was way too small to ride it, but they let me on anyways, and I almost fell out.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
That sucks. Oh, the pedigree! The pedigree!
Oh,
that's the
shit.
Second one, actually.
That might actually be it.
Flips him over. Hook of the leg. One.
Two.
Wow. Jack Six is a prestigious man. He's not going to go down to 2 pedigrees.
Master Chief is even... He's even pleading
Master
with
Chief
the
is dead. Oh, my God!
The mission.
How can like a fucking crocodile hunter hold on?
I mean, Jack Six is wearing green. DDT!
Like, I would imagine the crocodile hunter to get a crocodile.
It's like Steve Irwin with a crocodile.
Ooh, Jack Six is going to leave their all taunting Master Chief.
And what we got here is a...
He just so easily put Master Chief on his shoulder. Snake Eye.
Damn. Now you... What we've got here is a wild Jack Six. Now we're going to put him in this submission hold. Whoa, he's a wily one.
He's going in his death row.
He tells me he's from the future.
I'm going to jam my thumb up his bum hole and see how he reacts to that.
What? Hey, crikey.
The Wi-Fi connection was lost.
All right, sorry, guys. We don't have Wi-Fi in the arena anymore.
Yeah,
we still
have. As we watch,
it's a PSA. Yeah, if you're trying to connect to the Wi-Fi in the arena, it's out.
Technical problems. We'll fix those, guys.
Two,
one,
Jack Six. He's actually our on-site tech. Yeah, he's our on-site technician who's being called to fix the Wi-Fi that match at the end.
Matt, and his Bluetooth helmet just went down.
What are we doing?
We're commentating over
wrestling. Making the best of it. So, you know what's weird? Master Chief has won the Galactic title 3 times. Master Chief has won the Galactic title 3 times and the main title once. Jack Six has won the main title 3 times and the Galactic title once.
That is weird.
So
Just weird.
Oddly coincidental.
Oddly
but
coincidental.
Fairly odd.
Goes on to an Elimination Chamber.
Indeed he does.
Which was, fun fact, the first time he faced Master Chief, too.
Fun fact!
That is, that fact is fun. It's a fun one.
Did you have fun during the fact, Ryan?
What?
X6 goes on to the chamber.
Duh!
X6 has a 1-in-6 chance of becoming the next TMN Green Champion.
He does.
You can't go wrong with those odds.
Here now comes Ash Ketchum.
Oh, yeah.
He's, it's gonna be maybe in the next Elimination Chamber qualifying match. He's had a couple weeks, he wrestled twice last week.
Yeah, yeah.
Losing one of them.
He did. He did lose one of them. But, you know, he's the first match he had was the Patreon match.
But he... to get into contention.
For the Solar Flare title, yes.
Ooh. And now he's in
a light
for the vacant green title.
He is. Is that Kylo Ren? Why is he here? What qualifies him to be here?
Absolutely nothing. Huh.
Absolutely nothing. But I guess here he is. Bojack, what are you doing? What is Bojack doing? He's gonna put
your infinity. Watch him.
Kylo Ren.
So I guess it'll be Ash versus Kylo Ren, the winner getting into the Elimination Chamber match. I mean, you know what? I guess it makes a little sense. You know, Jim and Jim. first title here. He ended up taking that first one. Yes, he did. Yes, it is.
Big deal. Yeah. Kylo Ren had a match against Yugi Moto, Spawn, and Batman? Why did I not know this happened?
It's terrible.
It's a shame. That sounds really good. It's not a good concept.
It was a trash match. Kylo Ren.
No title wins under his career, but possibly he could change that.
He could pop, yeah. That's if he gets
and we're off.
If he gets into, if he wins the match here, it'll be eligible. But now, just a slam there by Ash, a wrestling slam.
Yeah, Ash is a prestigious wrestler as well, formerly known as Fuckface. Oh, it was a Hell in a Cell. No wonder why it was bad.
Trash. Heap. Yeah. It was a trash heap.
Right. Let's look at Ash.
Kind of like my mouth, huh?
All right.
I eat garbage.
That's good God. Ash has four different title belts under his name. But he has yet to win one in TMN Green. So, will he change that?
I mean, he's got to win his match first. And he got kneed in the gut. That's just no good.
So, getting kneed in the gut really doesn't help that.
From my experience, it does not.
Yeah. From experience and, scientific studies show.
Yeah.
Uppercut.
Those studies are scientific.
Yeah, 9 out of 10 doctors agree. We don't know what they agree with, but they just agree.
Oh, and Raditz is getting knocked out
again!
Wow.
Jesus Christ. Top rope. I mean,
he's got...
Ash. Brains again.
Oh, knee to the side of the head.
Ooh, oh, Trevor. We got a figure four locked in. Figure four.
In the match. Early.
That's an odd kind of figure four. That's not even a... Okay, it was like a variation of the figure four.
Ash is trying out right now. Oh.
I mean, he had
in the hat.
He had Pikachu... used Thundershock on the horn and that worked, so I mean Ash is an own improviser. Was that a crotch chop?
It was a suck it thing from DX, yes.
I think it was a crotch chop, yeah.
Hold on.
Uh oh.
Ash is a high flyer randomly. Oh, oh no.
Perfect.
What a fucking loser.
Botch.
Fucking. Oh shit.
Oh, you did. Go, Ash.
Oh my god. Now Ash is getting fucking abused.
Just landed face first on concrete, wouldn't you?
Oh my god.
Fucking.
That was one of the fucking funny. Yeah.
That was a perfect cut. Two.
Kylo Ren, getting out of what Ash is doing. Suplex.
I'm going to let you guys have that one. It's all.
Oh man, it was a great. Ash back in the ring, though.
That was one of the best fucking moments I've ever witnessed.
One of the best moments, I think, was when you accused... Oh, top rope drop! Oh, you missed.
Oh,
when
amazing.
You accused Captain Ginny of doing 9/11.
I'm doing 9/11.
Oh, what the fuck? That was even worse.
It was like a double axe handle. I didn't even use that. He's like a knee.
He hit him with like the end of it. slightly tapped color one side.
He didn't get all of it, you know.
Tried to stomp.
Did not get all of it. Stomping on Kylo Ren now.
I'm trying to break his arm. He's just really pissed off after messing up that flip, dude.
I mean, I would be. It's gotta fucking hurt. Ooh, the textbook. Textbook headlock applied. Textbook.
Page 107.
Second paragraph 2.
Yeah, you look up how to apply headlock in a textbook, and that is...
That's what you find.
Would be a picture of Ash Ketchum putting Kylo Ren in a headlock.
Ooh, shoulder block. Sunset flip by Kylo Ren into a pin.
Ooh.
Raditz doesn't recognize it right away. One. Two. Ooh. Oh, God.
Whoop.
Oh, there's two in reverse. Two.
Oh, son of a bitch.
Another
one. Reverse to back.
Two.
And another reverse back. Another reverse back. Oh.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
We're all better people for that happening.
I miss the old days that would go on for like 10 or 20 tries.
Yeah, oh, you miss them? Really?
Shades of 2K14.
You missed them.
Kylo Ren is just kneeing Ash in the face over and over again.
Who do you guys got in this match?
He's a child.
I am.
What a kid.
You know what? Before the match started, I would have said Ash, but I'm going to say Kylo Ren.
I want Ash to win, but I feel like Kylo Ren's going to win.
It has to be Ash. What are you guys talking about?
Oh, in the ropes.
Has to be Ash.
I mean, seeing him flub that moonsault so badly makes me not gonna.
One! Why does it have to be Ash, Andy?
He is in contention for Champion of Champions. As we watch him go on a roll.
People's elbow. Damn it. I was excited for it. The possibility of the people's elbow. Oh!
Flipping over the shoulders.
Right over.
But as it has been lately, Ash is
taking him down. All right. I was gonna. No, just tapping the thigh.
Ash Ketchum throwing Kylo Ren now into the near corner. Ooh, elbow.
Counters.
Elbow. Snapmare. Oh, powerful kick.
Holy God.
Getting all that heel.
Hook. Oh, it's a rope break.
Oh, Ash reaching for the rope.
Yes, that's what happened there.
But, yeah.
Reached for the rope.
The ring presence reach of Ash. Or whatever the
reach
holy.
For the sky.
There's a snake in my butt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, there is. His name's Tyrone.
Kylo Ren working the
okay,
arm.
Okay, let's take it easy now.
Trying to break his arm off. I have no comeback for that. Sorry.
This is no submission. He's just trying to rip his arm off.
He's trying to rip it clean up and then beat him with it. Or use it as the hilt for his next poorly crafted lightsaber. I'd have to imagine. It's just a guy's arm.
Oh,
He holds hands with it to hold onto it. It's adorable.
Oh no! Every time he like turns it on, like a little blood comes out
because it's very poorly made.
Yeah. Oh, Kylo Ren going to the top.
Okay, top.
He doesn't fly unless it's in a spaceship.
Oh, what was
what
that?
What a splash! Oh. It's like a.
Venetian like, headbutt.
Ooh. The Death Star drop.
Oh, good one.
Bridging pin there. Oh. Two
and a Starkiller duplex.
Alliteration's not real, okay? So it's a fake thing.
Alliteration?
How about assonance? It's
just what
the government just made alliteration up.
And hook of the leg. Yeah. One, two.
Near fall.
I learned pissed off about it, like everything else in the movies.
Yeah, throw a temper tantrum.
Ash with the counter. Reverse DDT.
See, before Kylo Ren entered
getting ready
match,
for something. I think he's gonna do a kick.
Ooh, super kick!
Staggers his opponent.
Uh-oh. Another submission.
Yeah.
Another submission. Nope.
To go for a pick.
One. Two.
Yes!
Wow!
Ash Ketchum with the win.
And that's gotta be Ash.
Color me surprised.
You know, it's a shame because before this match, Kylo Ren looked in the mirror and said, "You're gonna win the Korean Men title like your grandfather did." But
accurate. That is accurate. Darth Vader is in that Asian Green Champion.
Is he on green or blue right now?
He is on green.
Oh.
He was kicking around on Thunder for a while. He's probably still down there. Maybe we'll see him this week. Who knows?
Who knows?
Who knows?
Elimination Chamber qualifies. He's very qualified.
I'd say who knows?
Who knows?
Shadowed.
What?
Shadow knows?
Darth Vader have a name.
I don't get the reference you're trying to make me get, Andrew. I'm sorry.
That's like putting his phone.
If you stop lagging, I'll be able to understand a little better.
Yeah. You know what?
I don't know.
Fuck you guys.
I heard that.
God damn it.
Definitely heard that.
Did he beat Boo initially, or did he beat Captain America initially?
I think he beat Boo for the first time. And then he beat Captain America the second time, I believe.
Oh, yeah, because Boo... Yeah, he beat Boo, and then Captain America cashed. Mm.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, he beat Captain America. Yes. Oh, yeah, no, because he won it in the championship scramble. Yeah.
Oh, what's this? Oh,
Kylo
Darth
Ren.
Malik?
What?
Whoa! I said Kylo Ren. Darth Malik. Attacking Ash Ketchum.
That's it. No need for that.
Oh, all right.
Here we all are. Right. I wish you could change the title that they hold when you do a champion, but I'm just stuck with the default title. If you guys don't understand that, maybe you should follow the Twitter and the website a little more to see what's going on there. That's a little... little hint, you know, little hint-a-roo, you know?
Hint-a-roo?
Yeah, if you want to keep abreast with Magnation Cannon, you got a key website.
Got to keep abreast.
Speaking of abreast.
Yeah, Android 18.
You misogynist pig.
Whoa, PC Principal just gishing me a yellow card.
That all right, pun. Zinedine Zidane, let's settle down here.
I'll be back.
Javier's going to go to the bathroom.
There are no potty breaks.
Oh man, I remember when he headbutted that dude, and like people were making all those like edits of it. Those were the good old days. Like him going like getting Super Saiyan hair, headbutting him.
Those were the days, man. Those were the days.
Oh, the way of the Bee Gees.
How many years ago was that? Like 10? Probably more,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. No, more than 10. You know what? I actually don't know. Yeah, fuck. When did that happen?
It's either 04 or 08.
Let's see.
Had to be 04 then. Could not have, it can't be 08. I refuse to believe that.
Because that's good.
Actually, no, that's 10 years ago. So
2006.
2006?
It was the World 2006 World Cup.
So it was 12 years ago.
Yeah. I was going to say 2006, but I wasn't entirely sure myself.
Well, good thing you didn't, because you would have been fucking wrong, you dumb retard.
Yeah, I would have looked real stupid.
Yeah!
Yeah, my mom says, she says I'm a good boy.
Is that what your mom says? Your mom
it's says? She
says worse things about me. Anywho.
Sorry, we should never... Dez, where
do you Bobcat Goldblith? Is that who you are?
Yep.
I'm coming, you lugubriousness.
I used to beat the shit out of you. Why are you so fat? Shut up. You have any idea what that movie that's from?
No.
I'm going to assume one of the police academies.
No, good guess though. It is 80s.
I really don't know anything Bobcat Goldthwait did outside of Police Academy.
It's One Crazy Summer with John Cusack.
Oh. He also did Windy City Heat.
And he was that bunny.
Here comes Diva. Here comes Diva. She's the tag team partner of Android 18. Former Supernova champion Android 18, mind you.
Mind you.
Yes, that's a really great looking diva. Whoever did that. Bravo. Good job to that guy.
Bravo.
You made Steve horny. Good job.
No.
She's like 16.
Yeah, I'm just talking about the the craftsmanship.
Okay, here. Well, first of all, she's 19.
Alright.
Let me respond to that. No.
Yeah. They could have her in canon be like 84, and that wouldn't change anything. She's still a fucking animated like cartoon. Here is now your Supernova champion. That's Hawkgirl.
Hawkgirl.
Won the title after cashing in her Miss Money in the Bank contract. And now here she is. Here she is.
Is this a new Hot Girl model? It looks a lot better than I remember.
I don't know. Honestly, I'm not too sure. I don't believe so. I think I've kind of had the same like the same ones for.
All right. Oh, she's pointing the bat. Oh, she's Babe Ruth in it.
Call the shot.
Straight and at the former.
Imagine if Babe Ruth like fucking missed the next swing like after he did that.
There are many reports saying that he never did that in the first place.
That he didn't point
some
the bat.
Kid.
Well, he didn't call a shot. Like oh, that. Okay. Yeah, there are a lot of reports saying that. So
they said he was just like pointing it back at the pitcher, like Ichiro used to.
Yes, Babe Ruth learned from Ichiro.
No, Ichiro's the reincarnation.
Yeah. No, Shohei Ohtani is the reincarnation of Babe Ruth.
Indeed.
I didn't mention
baseball references.
Got lit up against the Red
yeah,
Sox.
I don't watch baseball.
Yeah, I know.
To quote Eric Andre, I don't give a shit about baseball.
Do you give Widow. A shit about Black Widow?
What's her story?
Sick. Okay, this is a really good-looking Black Widow model, I must say.
Wow, look at that. You made Ryan horny.
Fuck off!
Did you not think that was going to be happening, Ryan? Did you?
No. Because you're better than that, Steve.
Am I? Really?
Is he? I would expect him to be.
You think so?
CEO of this company.
Yeah.
Okay, let's not call it a company. We're all adults here. Okay. we all know what this is, guys. We're just fucking around, all right? Stop using those.
I built this company with my bare hand.
From the go.
Like I actually got like wood planks of wood with like nails and hammers. Shit.
And then I found bare hands on Amazon, and I.
I put them on my bare hands. I put bare hands on my bare hands.
B-E-A-R hands. Bare hands. Okay.
Black Widow kicking the shit out of that turnbuckle.
Bare hands on my bare hands.
All right, Ryan. So you had a story you wanted to tell us?
Oh, yes. Yeah. Okay, so... So I don't think I've ever actually told this story on Magnation. I told it to, like, various friends and such and like my brothers but yeah, so basically the reason why I bring the story up is because I have an update to it. So Javier, you might actually remember the story. Last semester I was walking home from my job at the university where I record concerts. It was late at night. It was like 10 o'clock at night, and I was walking home. And while I was walking, I hear from, like I kind of see, like, this white car, like, you know, drive, like, a little bit alongside me on the road. And from the car, I hear, "Hey, baby." I'm like, okay, yeah, no way they're talking to me. I'm just, you know, going to keep walking. And, like, after a few seconds, I hear it again. "Hey, baby." And I was like, well, okay, I think I'll look. So, you know, I look over, you know, at the driver, and it's just, you know, this... regular, you know, looking girl, you know, driving. She, you know, she's like in her early 20s, and you know, she's talking to me. I was like, hello. She was like, "Hey, do you remember me?" And I said, "No." She was like, "Wait." Yeah, she was like, "Wait, really? You don't remember me?" I was like, "No, I can't say that I do. Sorry." She was like, "What? Are you serious?" Like she was like kind of like getting upset about it. I was like, "No, I don't remember. I don't know who you are. You know, I'm sorry." Like I tried to keep walking. You know, I was like kind of like looking over at her because she like, you know, was still driving alongside me. Like I guess she thought like I was like fucking with her or something. So the next thing she says, "I put a plastic bag over your head." And I was like, "Excuse me?" She's like, yeah, you don't remember that? I put a plastic bag over your head. I was like, no, I'd remember something like that.
Wait. So where did this happen?
When I was walking home. It was pretty much still on campus.
All right, so this happened how long ago?
It was late last year. I'd say probably like October or November around there.
Somehow this story has an update.
Yes, because I'll get to it. Trust me, this will make sense.
Not even over here. I love it.
Well, I was saying like that seemed like a pretty one-off kind of thing. How in the world?
Yeah, no. Okay, no, I know, but yeah, just hold on. Let me finish.
Bulldogs.
Yeah, so she's like, you know, like she's like, I put a plastic bag over your head, and I was like, no, you didn't.
Nope, you didn't. No.
Yeah. She was like, are you kinky? I was like, yeah, I started laughing. I was like, what are you talking about? She was like, are you kinky? I said, no, I'm not.
No.
She was like, okay, then. And gave me, like, a weird look, and then she drove off. I was like, I just kind of, like, stood there for a few seconds, and I was like, did that really just, like, fucking happen? I was like, okay.
Was she cute?
So, oh, yeah, she was pretty cute. But like,
nice. So you should have went with it, bro.
Nice.
Oh, no, you kidding?
No, I'm not. No, okay. First of all, if I pretend to be somebody else and like she fucks me under that pretense, that's essentially rape because I am not the person she's fucking me, thinking that I'm somebody else. Okay, so that's number one. Number two, we could be doing it, and she could put a plastic bag over my head. And I don't know the safety word, so she's just going to keep it over my head, and I'm going to die from suffocation.
Safety words before.
Yeah, no, because like I could hit her and get her off of me, but then what am I going to tell the police? Sorry, officer, I was pretending to be somebody else so she would fuck me, and then when I didn't know the secret fucking, the safety word,
the
I
secret code word, yeah.
Yeah.
Code word.
To let me make me live.
So that's why I didn't fucking seize that opportunity, because it would be fucked up if I did. But yeah, but anyways, so I'm standing there and I'm thinking, okay, this is one of three things. First, and what I think is most likely is she was just fucking with me. You know, like she just saw some, like, you know, because there was nobody else around. She saw some random dude walking down the street and she was like, hey, you know, I'm going to fuck with this guy and it will be funny. So that's what at the time what I thought was most likely. Number two was this bitch is fucking stupid, because I am a very unique man. I look pretty unique and I sound pretty unique. There are not very many people who sound like me. And, you know, so like, what are the odds that there's somebody who looks and sounds like me? And that brought me to number three, and the least likely was there is somebody in this town who looks and sounds exactly like me to the point where she would mistake me for him. So,
fucker.
Fast forward.
Number four.
Yeah, fast forward to about a month ago.
Oh, boy.
I'm in Safeway. I'm buying groceries for the week.
That's half of safe word, by the way.
Yeah, so yes, but yeah. So when I get to this, like, you guys are gonna like put this together immediately. I did not come like to this conclusion until like a week or two ago. But anyways, I'm in Safeway. Oh. I'm getting food, and I, you know, I go
as
up to the cashier.
One does.
Yeah, and you know, he rings up my shit, whatever, and then I'm kind of just, like, looking, like, down, like, the aisles at, like, the rest of the cashiers while I'm waiting for him to, like, ring up the stuff because I'm bored. And I see one of the cashiers, and this motherfucker looks exactly like me.
Are you serious?
Exactly like me.
He
has, like, my short hair, like, the hair that I have now. Like, he had, like, the same fucked up jaw. He had the same fucking, like, Neanderthal brow that I had.
He had the same fucking terrible flaws that I have.
Exactly. Yeah, no, exactly, right? He's overweight, you know, and fucking he had the fucked up jaw and the Neanderthal brow. Flaw. Like, he looked like me to a fucking T.
Can we talk about Hawkgirl flying in to break up that pin, by the way? That's pretty cool.
Yeah. Anyways, like, the only difference is that, like, he was maybe a couple inches shorter, and his face was, like, completely pale. You know, I have, like, these rosy cheeks. Like, that's one of my defining features, but, like, his face was completely pale. Yeah, and so I was like, wow, what the fuck? That guy looks just like me. Like I was tripping about it. And then a few weeks later, you know, I'm like walking home from school, and it hits me, and I was like, oh, wait a minute. The kinky girl, that guy. She thought I was that guy.
Wait, you didn't talk to that guy?
Just like me. No, he was a couple aisles down.
Oh,
fuck. Yeah, was he a cashier?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, you should go back there and ask him. Yes.
Yeah, I've every single time I've gone back there, I've looked for him, and he has not been there since. I don't think he's.
No, I think he's like.
Or
he's
maybe he works
you.
There at night. I might have been there at night.
Well, he's you from the future, and you've broke the space time continuum by being in the same space.
But yeah, no, like because I was like, no, so like, it happened to be that there is someone who looks exactly fucking like me. And that's why she thought I was kinky, because she thought I was the kinky man, the kinky Safeway man. But I am not.
Oh, the kinky... Black Widow straddling that second rope. Space-time continuum. There we go.
And that is my story.
Safeway man.
Yeah.
What a
that's
tale.
My story of the kinky lady and the kinky Safeway man who looks just like me.
Kinky Safeway. If there's any
animators watching this, go ahead and. Please.
The plastic bag she was talking about was a plastic bag from where he works.
Oh, holy fucking shit.
They did it in the back room at Safeway.
Yeah. And she put a plastic bag over his head.
Yeah, the safe like, word was Safeway. Oh shit. It's quite
the safe
divine.
Word was lower prices guaranteed. So anyway, and Hawkgirl.
It's like she was doing it with Billy Mays.
Billy Mays the here.
Word. The safe word is, but wait, there's more.
Which seems awfully counterintuitive for what a safe word should be.
Exactly. Right.
One, two near fall. We're back.
Going through that second rope again.
Hawkgirl taunts.
Hawkgirl, and there's Diva and Andrew 18 laying on the center of the mat.
Hawkgirl, who's live right now? Who is the fucking supposed to be in the ring?
Hawkgirl's not too sure. I don't know. We listened to Ryan's great story.
Great story. Great story, sir.
Oh, that Thank was you. A good story.
Yeah, I could have sworn I told you about the first story though, Steve.
It's possible you did, but it might have been, you know, it didn't.
Yeah, I think I told you shortly at like within like a week or two. So it was it was like 5 or 6 months.
Yeah,
that's a while.
Yeah, you don't remember that, Javier?
They're both on the. They're just laying down. This match is taking it out of them.
I wonder if Nick or Lynn would remember, because I remember for a fact, and Kyle, because I remember telling them.
Bodies in the line. Oh, he's in the line. DDT by Diva.
An emphatic DDT. Going for the pin.
So
one.
And
two.
Black Widow breaks it up as she gets thrown into the corner by Android 18. He is now
top rope
on the offensive.
And she is perched flying. Oh, Hawkgirl
oh,
catching her.
Oh, but she's caught.
Throws her over.
Caught Diva
her shoulder.
Like a hawk oh. catches a fish.
Guillotine.
Right.
Out of the air.
References.
Ruh-roh, Scooby.
Like Scoob.
Like Zoink Scoob.
Overhead jawbreaker. Let's smoke a doob. Let's smoke a doob.
Rash crash.
Oh, gory bomb! Center of the ring.
As
tying up those legs into Texas cloverleaf.
Okay.
Texas cloverleaf.
Is she gonna tap?
Looks like she's tapping already.
Nope.
But she must just be spasming from all the pain.
Yeah, probably. And sweep of the leg. She's gonna, yep, she's tagging out.
In comes Android 18.
Time to let out some aggression.
The deadly
DDT.
DDT.
Yeah, at the last
Black Widow wants to be tagged in.
At the last pay-per-view, Hawkgirl cashing in her Money in the Bank contract on the victorious Android 18 to become a new. What a Pele kick!
Oh, wow.
Rest.
Snap suplex there from a champion trying to extend
sidewalk slimy
slammy Jerry
sidewalk slammy DDT
sidewalk mammy jammy.
Yeah, weren't there like awards called the slammies?
Yes, for wrestling. Yes, there were. There were awards called the Slammies.
Yes, sadly.
Top row for Black Widow. Calling for Andrew 18 to rise to her feet. Oh, she misses. Oh, but she gets right back up.
Wriggles out of it. That should be the new DDT.
Should be the what?
Throws the new corner.
Like Bulldog, take a drink.
Oh, what is this? Oh!
A tornado DDT from the middle rope.
As Raditz back dashed a couple times there.
See, in Ultimate Universe, Raditz fought Andrew 18 and it didn't end well, so he doesn't want to repeat that.
We deal with some pretty sweet fan fiction.
Canon?
Oh, it's going for a Fishman suplex, but a counter by Black Widow, then recover one.
One.
Two. Kick out.
Hawkgirl has stopped giving a shit in there. She's like, eh. It'll work out.
I'm still the fucking champion. I don't give a fuck.
What a reverse suplex by Black Widow.
Shit, why does she sound like Vince McMahon? Oh, into the corner.
Oh. Just bouncing off that corner.
Dude, what a pin by 18. One.
Into a bridge.
Two.
Hawkgirl takes a swing. And Raditz got fucking hit.
Man, he's... Oh, the twist of fate. Twist of fate by Andrew 18.
Uh-oh. Even get in there.
One.
There.
Two.
Oh, it's Hawkgirl interrupts it.
Uh-oh. Oh, choke slam?
She's going to get choke
slam? Oh, no.
Ooh.
You know.
Get off the fucking stage. Go back to overall.
Twisted Fate now to Black Widow. Both members of that team are down. One. Two. No! Black Widow kicking out. Black Widow kicking out.
Yeah, when Diva grabbed her, it reminded me of like Undertaker grabbing someone for a choke slam.
Right? It's I thought fun. There was going to be a sick choke slam, but...
I mean, I guess Diva is the shortest member of the match.
And running through the turnbuckle.
Right? Dr. Jarrell, man. He did not account for her being a wrestler, I think.
See, he didn't program how to climb a top rope, right? So.
Yeah. Murder and destruction? Yeah, but climbing in the turnbuckle? That's a bit of a challenge.
You got to give us a few more years for that.
What is wrenching the... little old school? No, what an arm drag.
Whoa.
Acrobatic.
Whoa.
A hawk girl. Whoa.
She is a hot girl after all, so she would be able to do a bunch of aerials.
Fun. She's a hawk girl after all.
Okay.
You going for another one?
She's a hawk girl after
all. Another one. She has three friends now.
Das the five von Dean Destoy.
One, two. Even breaking that up.
Diva wants this W, man.
He wants some credibility, so she
face Hot girl faces off against Diva.
He's like, you fucking stop that shit again.
Taunts right
taunting right in her face.
Wow.
And Diva. Turnbuckle.
She's not functioning.
She doesn't know how to climb stuff. She just knows how to fly, all right?
Speaking of gonna fly.
Okay, Andrew 18 not gonna tag.
She's not gonna let her.
That could have been great. What a clothesline.
Ooh. That would have been. She could have been like Shane McMahon. Coast to coast. Or Space Ghost, I mean. Who's Shane McMahon?
Who's Shane McMahon?
Andrew 18, just,
looming over her opponent, and now going to the outside.
Oh.
And takes D.Va on the way down.
Landing on D.Va, yeah. Andrew 18 has a kid, right?
Krillin? Yes.
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 Marin. Which is weird because that was the name of Krillin's first girlfriend as well. So.
Yeah. It was. It was.
That's just kind of weird that Krillin named his daughter after his first.
The one that got away.
Not a good Uh-oh. Double DDT.
Double DDT.
He just went on the out here.
D.Va keeps climbing up and jumping down. Ooh. I think D.Va's trying to get some leg action.
He's trying to break the pin off. He can't. He's trying to look. You go first.
Got them calves.
Oh, Android 18 breaking up. Okay.
Who the lead right now?
It's 18 and Hawkgirl, but like Android 18 some reason broke up the count.
At least Javier knows because I am fucking not sure.
Oh, one, pin one,
two.
Kick out by Hawkgirl.
Yeah, watch that. Oh no.
18 is fucking pissed. There, go right.
Jesus Christ!
Holy fucking shit!
You fear the hell out of her.
She just fucking skull bashed the shit out of her.
Oh, fuck out of Hawkgirl.
Okay, somebody loop that headbutt she just did right there. Like, put like some heavy metal.
Dude, she is fucking pissed, dude.
Fuck, I'll do it.
Thanks, Javier.
Twist of fate to Hawkgirl, center of the ring.
Black Widow's still down.
Still down.
Look at the leg. Is this gonna do it?
That has to do.
Two.
Oh, God.
She's the champion for a reason. She's got stamina.
Android 18's having it. Climb.exe not found.
What is this strange contraption?
Syntax error.
Is he gonna tag in D.Va? Oh no, Hawkgirl not allowing it.
Counter by 18, reverse DDT.
Take a drink.
For a tree of woe. Didn't get it.
Tree of woe.
Tree of woe.
Whoa.
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 Whoa, 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 whoa.
She's breakdancing now.
Yeah. I think her CPU's starting to overheat.
Trying to iterate, she's running low on battery or something. She just stopped things.
Running low on battery, he says.
She's an Android, right? I don't know.
Paul Krillin.
Within the lore of Dragon Ball Z, she has a
She has a what?
Unlimited energy.
Oh, okay.
Does she need to sleep?
She's part human and Android. Yeah.
I mean, they don't say anything about sleep or anything like that. It's just she can like endlessly. She can endlessly like just like throw blasts. Pretty much.
Okay.
Same.
Well, she's like human in the part where she has a reproduction system.
One, two. Old Man Raditz is running interference.
Old Man Raditz.
Old Man Raditz.
Get out of here.
Just yelling at him.
Get off my lawn.
Has anyone seen my double son?
God damn it, Hawk!
Okay, why can't no one climb? Are the ropes? Are the
Error.
Can nobody use these effectively? Like, or even, like, realistically?
The first few matches were fine, but,
yeah. Yeah, Android 18's malfunctioning. Hawk Girl is just like a hawk, so she doesn't know how to climb.
Yeah.
But she
flies. Fly she's up not allowed to fly. It's illegal. Well, she'll be banished.
Now, why does she have wings, Javier?
She'll be banished if she uses them.
Oh, trying to use the ropes now. One.
One.
Two.
Dirty pigs.
What the fuck are you doing, Raditz?
Okay. At this point, he just wants this match to end, probably.
We all do.
What a DDT!
He reversed.
What a counter.
Oh, dropped into the bed. She's had a lot of ferocity.
She wants her title back. She did not lose it the way she thought she would.
Man, she's just on the fucking...
Like, stay up.
But she tags in Diva. Diva drags.
For some more dragging.
Okay.
So she can do it dirty.
Oh, Diva's now.
One.
Doing
two.
Fucking rules like, eh, she's got this. Oh.
Hurricanrana.
Oh, see, there you go. Someone managed
middle row.
Measured the turnbuckle correctly. Amazing.
Oh, what? Is this a seesaw?
Sunset.
Is that a C4, I think? Or a Canadian destroyer?
Sunset flip.
C4. Canadian destroyer. Taking Florida basement.
That's illegal.
Oh, she's over an electric chair? Oh, she is.
Pin one. Two.
Ooh.
Hawkgirl.
Oh, it's a push. Plan invention morning.
Continues to kick out.
Got to do that as a champion, brother. Okay, Diva.
And now.
Come on, how'd you manage to climb it?
This turn and she's waiting on stop me. Style.
Can I block my style?
Take it out her knees.
That's been a great match.
Dude, I went to the DDT. Bathroom to tell a story, and this match is still going. Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
The Raw video file was 34 minutes.
Oh, my God.
My Lord.
Hook of the leg. One, two.
No! It will continue.
You guys are have winning this.
Uh-oh. Chokeslam for real this time? Nope.
Oh, nope. A counter.
Hawkgirl ain't having any of that shit at all. None of
Wait,
that
is
shit.
Is Diva Australian?
No.
No, Korean.
What? No, she's Korean.
You duh, you goof. You goofball. Oh,
she's not going to Bendigo to get her...
Oh, no! I put Diesel in the petrol!
With Morty, I gotta suck your little Morty penis, Morty. Gotta go to Bendigo to get me key. What is Diva doing? What is going on?
Kicking her leg. What is he doing?
Playing footsie.
Hey, tagging Andrew 18. He's like, I don't know what else to do.
Like, I'm trying to crawl away.
Andrew 18 looks pissed off at the match.
It's
still
her,
going on.
Yeah, she's just got places to be. She's got to pick up Marin from fucking soccer practice. This has gone way too long.
Where are you going? Don't go to Raditz.
Go visit Krillin on his ship.
Uh-oh.
Hawkgirl gonna fly. But not like...
Just right there!
Come on. You're gonna... Okay.
You blocked her!
You baited her. Oh,
yeah. Right. Fucking baited. Baited.
Twist the fate.
They're getting caught on. Will that be all?
Please.
Hook of the leg.
Hook of the leg. One. Two.
That's gotta be it.
Wow. This, like, can this just end?
Hey, that was a classic match, alright? You guys are...
Yeah, that was a good
one.
You guys are the worst.
I told a funny story. Some good things happened, like, within the match itself.
But the focus there, of course, was Ryan's story. Of course, Ryan will tell you that himself. Sorry, I was lagging. Just doing a little
Bushland Adventures finally over, Morty.
Little lagaroo, you know.
I'm in the Ute now.
Yeah, I was gonna say yeah. You became the family Ute, Morty.
Diva, so happy that this match is over.
I'll take you to the bush dimension, Morty. You can pee there. Look right over there, Morty. Go, yeah, it's on that tree. Yeah, Morty.
Falcon in perfect cell.
Main event this evening, gentlemen. Main event.
Andy, oh, it's to see who...
Main eventing.
Yeah, Andy, you let us know what's going on, Andy. What's this match about?
The two winners. Triple threat matches.
You lagging. Try again.
Triple threat match winner.
Yes.
For title.
Which one?
Solar for title. Solar flare. Title. Number one contender.
Yep. There you go.
Herein,
Baltimore, Maryland.
Baltimore. You're going to witness this star-stud match.
That pyro actually wasn't pyro. That was just two dumpsters on fire. Because we're
Falcon. At Falcon.
Yes!
Yeah, I thought of that. I thought of that and I said it. I'm so funny.
At Falcon!
Okay, calm down, Bill Burr.
There you go.
Man, I can't wait to see Falcon in a new Infinity War. Looks a little different, though, from the trailers.
As he took up an occupation, a side job, racing space vehicles, actually.
Falcon! So.
Falcon, oh, yeah.
Fun fact, Count Falcon won a tag team title from his debut, I'm pretty sure.
If you go to his page, you can see exactly what
yes,
matches.
I am correct. Wait, no, I'm not. Fuck.
No, you're not correct, you stupid
That's
the
idiot. Second match, god damn it.
It's totally different things. So the winner of this match will take on Zamasu for the Solar Flare title at the next pay-per-view event at the end of May.
Which will be titled?
It's on the page somewhere.
Battle of Naboo 2, Electric Boogaloo?
We already had Battle of Naboo 2.
Ryan,
I believe, didn't we? We had Invasion of Geonosis 2. I think we had Order 66. So I think it actually might be Battle
of Naboo.
Is the
next one Escape from the Namek? Not Namek. Naboo.
Escape from Namek.
I said Namek. I said Naboo. Fuck.
Fuck, you said Namek. Said Naboo. What the fuck, Morton? Damn it, Harvey.
I seem to have dropped my Android.
Look at that fucking smile on his face.
He's perfection.
He's happy
man.
To be here. Man.
I am perfection.
Cell has not won a title yet in the Magnation. So
who? Cell? That was yeah. He hasn't been around that long.
Well, it's been around since 14.
I mean, yeah, but how many matches has he been in? Not a lot.
Oh,
what
yeah.
A punch in the gut.
He had to skip two generations, right?
Yeah. What a German suplex.
Jesus.
Good lord.
He had to go wrestle over in Japan for a while.
Japan. Under the name El Cell.
El Cell.
He was not a big fan of that joke, for what it's worth.
It was not a perfect joke.
El Cell.
Towering over Captain Falcon.
Oh my lord.
Captain Falcon, former tag team hardcore and galactic champion. Fun fact.
Really?
Oh, he showed me his moves.
One. Kick out.
Looking for the Falcon upset.
See, do you have the rankings on here, or is that only on your thing?
That is on there, but they haven't been updated in a little while, but they'll be updated for this show. So.
Captain Falcon tossing Cell. Cell is towering over Falcon. I didn't even notice this.
Yeah.
Perfect Cell's foot is like the size of Falcon's upper body.
He didn't even have to do anything. He just like had to
just bumped into him.
Oh my god.
Good god. Cell's height.
Maniacal laugh.
Oh,
he got him over!
Oh, wow,
what a weird take!
Wow, he just went.
No one right. Won the match yet, Andy.
Huh?
He said he got him over.
Who do you got? Who do you guys get winning this match anyway?
I got Falcon.
Let's what a neat! I'll go with Captain Falcon.
Perfect set.
I mean, he is your hero, and he will take pollution down to zero.
You're banned from this, Captain Planet.
He'll go to like a trash bag and Falcon punch it.
Yes.
He just gets trashed over the street, but we don't tell him because you know he's trying.
At least he doesn't put it over Ryan's head.
So I'm just punching away, Captain Falcon.
Callback.
Callback.
Ah.
Yes. Oh.
Ooh, slammed.
When he picks him up, he is high return buckle. That is just a long way to drop when he picks him up.
Falcon kick.
Oh, Falcon drop.
Falcon,
pick up.
Double leg.
Falcon fuck.
Falcon chokehold. Very classical.
Oh my god, look at those scrawny
funny arms. Like, turn around. Around him. Holy fuck. Oh, reversed. Reverse DDT, take a drink.
Falcon reverse DDT.
Take it back now, y'all. Three hops this time.
Falcon knee drop.
Right foot, left stomp.
To the top. Left he doesn't use his fly unless he's in his racer pod.
Moves down. Oh. Drop. Wow.
Elbow by Captain Falcon.
Physics.
One. I need a two count.
Right foot, left stomp.
Falcon elbow to the shoulder.
Elbow to the clavicle.
Clavicle.
That's what's called.
Falcon precision elbows.
I wasn't saying it wasn't. Oh, trying to pick him up, but
yeah, that's a mistake.
Oh, I'm getting out of it.
Oh, club it. See how you like it.
He's like a foot and a half over Falcon. Jesus Christ.
All he can do is cover his face.
It's like this helmet isn't doing shit. It's just it's just looks like you look.
This helmet's just for looks, yeah. It's actually paper thin.
Where are you going, Perfect Cell? There we
That's
go.
Really dangerous when I drive, because this doesn't protect me at all.
Yeah, I can't even see. This is actually just like white cloth over my eyes. I can't damn thing.
Uh-oh.
Oh, go for a comment.
Kamehameha!
Kamehameha. That'd be it. See, Count Falcon is a Super Saiyan, so you can't take that. One, two, never mind.
Turns out you don't need to be a Super Saiyan to take that shit.
Yeah, Count Falcon's fight Smash Brothers. See, you know, he's fight Kamehameha.
Yeah, he's fight baseball bats.
Yeah, don't worry.
But not...
Oh, two! Goku's already in next match. Count Falcon's taking these.
One! Two.
Whoa!
Falcons. Still hanging in there. Come on, Falcon.
Near fall.
Make Perfect yourself Stella famous,
yelling
kid.
At old man Raditz.
I'll go for a cutter.
The quick jab!
Oh, Falcon Whoa. Kick! Oh, shit.
Cat of nowhere.
One. Two. Kick out at two.
Staggered Perfect Cell. Or El Cell.
El Cell.
Elbow to the gut.
El in a cell.
El Cell and Hell in a Cell.
El Cell's Hell in a Cell.
Cell's ready.
As he stands there menacingly.
Stoic. He's standing there. Godlike.
It's something he does well.
It's just like a DBZ battle for an episode, and then battle.
Oh. Ooh, the guillotine!
On the rope.
The guillotine.
Guillotine is a one-hit KO?
If it hits, yeah. 30%.
Yeah, it usually decapitates people. One, two!
Near fall, near fall. Cell, though. He's amped as shit.
He's still feeling himself.
Right foot, left stomp. A Ooh. Knee by Captain Falcon. He is Falcon. Trying to overcome the odds, dare
what
I say.
Oh, my lord.
It's an interesting
F-Zero drop.
Leg.
F-Zero drop.
One, two.
Kick out by Cell. He continues to fight. What a warrior he is, huh?
The diminutive Captain Falcon.
What a warrior he is.
Oh, oh my god!
Oh my god!
Another! Dropping
gonna get a third? Oh no!
Smoking up, brother.
Ooh!
He jumped 7 feet in the air to drop kick him in the face.
Oh, Falcon punch. End it. Oh no. So reversed it.
Snap suplex.
Nearly
into a perfect piss.
That Raditz just hesitated there for a second before.
That's what happens when your old man Raditz lose a step or two.
Oh, he instant going, transmission going, away.
Actually, would you say Goku died by Cell or like? Yeah.
Right? No, he killed himself. He killed himself.
Yeah.
It's no, that. I would say Cell killed him. Because he died because of the explosion of Cell.
But it was like,
Command Man's blocking.
And he made sure to take King Kai with him.
Fucking ass.
I know.
Hey, can I just drop this off here? Thanks.
He still hasn't wished him back to life.
He's still dead? Really?
Yeah, King Kai's like dead throughout like all of Dragon Ball Super. Oh, he never wished him back to life.
What a piece of shit.
Yeah, what an asshole.
And that fuck. Zell's really tired. He gotta absorb some new people in the crowd. He wants to stay in this match.
He just absorbed another episode. Zero drop. The upset.
Leg. One. Two.
Ooh.
Come on, Falcon. Fuck.
I believe in you.
Captain Falcon was this close. You can't see what I'm doing with my hands, but I'm making that. That little, you know, that.
Yeah.
My thumb and index finger are very close together. Yes, to signify.
I'm aware of what you're talking about.
To signify how close.
Well, Falcon
headlock.
Well, you get him with this.
I mean.
Or headlock. Yeah, you're right.
Or chin lock.
Is he going to tap out?
Oh, I don't know.
He is struggling.
He is nope.
Oh, nope.
He's going to roll out of the apron now to kind of catch his breath. Oh, down to the outside.
Dragging the rope with him.
Going to catch his breath.
Well, go fly, Falcon. Make yourself famous.
Top rope, top rope, top rope.
Oh, no.
Oh,
right
no,
to
not
the lines then. Reverse TDT. He's back in the ring.
That guy in the green sweater was not a fan of that. He's a self-aware. He was double thumbs down Falcon.
Come on, show me your moves.
What am I, count out? Okay, what was I say?
Show me your moves. Come on.
Show me your absorbing powers.
He's like, I'm not being kind of... He's not being kind of selling. I'm generally interested in what you got to bring to the table here.
Rub me in the ass in his face.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Yo, bitch.
Snake eyes, motherfucker. Gyrant.
Don't tell me he wins off that.
One, two.
Oh, come on, Falcon. Come on, Falcon. Come on, get up and do a Falcon punch.
Come on. Come on.
No. Yes.
Oh. Oh, he did the knee. He did the knee attack.
Falcon knee. Oh, almost taking out Raditz.
Oh, DDT no. By himself.
Oh, no.
There it is.
Breaking that momentum.
There it is. No. The Kamehameha. There
no.
It is.
Oh, the third one.
And he is white.
Kill yourself. Take one from the team.
Dragon screw. What are you going to do?
Come on.
Into the corner.
No.
Come on, Falcon. The hell?
He's putting him on the top rope.
Pick
what,
him off.
No. No.
And no.
Flying shoulder block.
His head smashing off that canvas. What are you doing?
Come on, get up. Get up. Get up.
Come on, Falcon. Come on, Falcon. Fuck.
Oh, no.
To the back of the head.
Another Kamehameha.
Oh, four. No.
Gotta be it.
Oh, God. Come on.
One, two.
Oh, God damn it.
I mean, that's what he gets for fucking rubbing his ass in someone's face. He wasn't fucking dancing like a jackass while Cell was climbing back into the ring.
Stupid sexy Falcon, that's what you get.
God damn it. Falcon went so fucking bad.
Yeah, same here.
More DBC.
He had to start fucking twerking his ass.
Starts clapping his ass cheeks and fucking tough face. Oh no.
Still goes on face some awesome.
With that being said, everybody, thank you all for watching. Yes, be sure to leave a like in the video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe for more. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Check out our website at mangation.com, m4gnation.com, and we will see you guys next time. Good night.
Good night.
Bye.
Late!